With that, we conclude discussion of synchronization and communication issues in parallel systems. The next part of the lesson will cover scheduling issues in parallel systems. You'll notice once again, when we discuss scheduling issues, that the mantra is always the same. Namely, pay attention to keeping the caches warm to ensure good performance. We're going to look at scheduling issues in parallel systems. Fundamentally, the typical behavior of any thread or a process running on a processor is to do the following. Compute for a while and then make a blocking I/O system call, or it might want to synchronize with other threads that it is part of in the application. Or it might be that it is a compute-bound thread, in which case it might just run out of the time quantum that it has been given by the scheduler on the processor. But fundamentally, what that means is this is a point at which the operating system, in particular the scheduler piece of the operating system, can schedule some other thread or a process to run on the CPU. So how should the scheduler go about picking the next thread or a process to run on the processor, given that it has a choice of other threads that it can run at any point of time?